I'm very pleased to have with us Dr. Stephanie Seneff, a senior research scientist at MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Their website, of course, web.mit.edu. Dr. Seneff, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be here.
I read this remarkable story, and I wanted to reality check it with you, about your asserting that as a consequence of glyphosate, correct my pronunciation if I have it wrong, the chemical that is sold.
Glyphosate, yes.
How do you say it?
Glyphosate. Everyone has trouble with it.
Glyphosate. Okay.
Glyphosate, yeah.
Thank you. Which is sold under the brand name Roundup, I believe.
Yes, right.
That as a consequence of the widespread use of this, that we could see half of all kids born in 2025 being autistic. Is that?
That's what I said. And now, you know, it could be an exaggeration, but even if it's just a quarter, it's still a huge problem, right? And when you project the curve that the CDC has been maintaining out to 2037, which is 12-year-olds today. So 12-year-olds today, currently 1 in 68, formerly 1 in 88, formerly 1 in 150. You project the curve. That's what you see. So, and I don't see anything changing. I mean, everything's getting worse every year, both the glyphosate usage and synergistic effects of vaccines. There are many chemicals in vaccines that are synergistically toxic with glyphosate.
Huh.
We're getting more vaccines on the agenda. We're getting more herbicides. You know, they're adding 2,4-D. Now they've got 2,4-D resistance on top of glyphosate resistance because we've got these runaway weeds. I mean, the agriculture is out of control in this country. We think chemical treatment, basically putting poisons on our crops, is the only way we can grow food. And for as long as we think that's the case, I think we're in serious trouble.
Now, the argument that Monsanto makes, and again, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm not the expert on this, you are, but I believe that the argument that Monsanto makes about the safety of glyphosate of Roundup is that it interrupts a metabolic pathway that is unique to plants and that is not it's not part of the human metabolism. Is that true? Is that what they say?
Well, first of all, it's not unique to plants. It's unique to everybody, basically, except the mammals, because it's unique to both plants and microbes, which is very important because we don't have the pathway. It's called the shikimate pathway in our cells. For that reason, we can't produce the product of the pathway. And the product of the pathway is incredibly important to our health, which is all the aromatic amino acids. They are precursors to things like serotonin, melatonin, melanin, various vitamins and all kinds of things. So
right.
We depend on our gut bacteria and on the plant supply to supply these nutrients for us. If they can't supply them, we're going to be deficient, and if we're deficient, we're going to be sick. So that's one thing. But more than that, it doesn't just disrupt that one pathway. They like to claim that it does, but the research has shown otherwise. And in particular, it also disrupts a class of enzymes called cytochrome P450 enzymes in the plants, in the microbes, and in the liver. This has been shown in experiments in all three of those classes of life. And so those enzymes are incredibly important. In the liver in particular, they detoxify all the other toxic chemicals in the environment. So when they're not working, everything becomes more toxic. And this is crucial because we're exposed to so many chemicals these days. And when you add glyphosate to the mix, even Tylenol can become toxic.
Yeah, well,
the drugs can become toxic.
Yeah, a lot of people die from Tylenol destroying their livers. I mean, that's a major
right.
problem.
Right, and that's part of it because glyphosate is making it easy for Tylenol to do that.
Really?
Yes.
Whoa, because it interrupts the enzyme, one of the enzymes
detoxifies Tylenol. Yes.
Right.
It's very crucial, and of course, it also then messes up the entire sulfate system. Sulfate is incredibly important for the health of the blood flow, the vascular health of the walls of the blood vessels. They're very disturbed by a lack of sulfate, and glyphosate disrupts the whole sulfate system. For example, the CYP enzymes are necessary for vitamin D activation in the liver. We face a vitamin D epidemic today. Everyone says, oh, yeah, you've got to take vitamin D supplements. That's the only way you're going to get enough. Everybody has deficiency. No one seems to be asking the question, why do we suddenly all have this deficiency in vitamin D? It's because of glyphosate. It disrupts the activation of vitamin D in the liver, which depends upon a CYP enzyme.
Whoa. So,
and it can explain also celiac disease. You know, all of a sudden everybody's allergic to wheat, and we're like, oh, yeah, wheat's toxic, you know. Of course, didn't you know that? Well, we didn't think that a few years back.
Right.
Now you've got all these, you know, sections in the grocery store of all this gluten-free food.
Right.
It's just come about
And that, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that that tracks back a decade or maybe a decade and a half ago to they never used to use Roundup on wheat, and they started using it on wheat 3 days before the wheat is harvested so that the plants would turn brown and be crunchy and more easily harvested. It doesn't gum up the machines like green, you know, living plants do. So they kill them off with the glyphosate, the Roundup. And they have a more efficient harvest, but now the wheat is contaminated with Roundup too.
Right.
Is that how it works?
Of course, it also gets a head start on next year's weeds. You know, they really like to advertise you can kill the weeds at the same time as you kill the crop.
Right.
So it seems like a great idea. And of course, if glyphosate's non-toxic, then sure, why not? But you're going to dump it right into the seed, and so wheat all of a sudden becomes toxic, and nobody seems to think it might be the glyphosate that's doing it, although it seems obvious to me.
Wow.
We've written a paper on that, by the way. Anthony Samsel and I have collaborated on a couple of papers that are sort of the background for this, my position on this subject. Glyphosate is a fascinating molecule.
It is, and it's
absolute train wreck to biology.
Some of the compounds that you mentioned, serotonin, melatonin, these are essentially hormone neurotransmitters, modulators of both the immune system and the emotional system. Is this the mechanism by which kids are being damaged to the point that they end up autistic?
I think so. I think it plays a major role, the serotonin, the melatonin. Melatonin is crucial for delivering sulfate to the brain, and that's another article that I've written, which is about to be published. I have another article I've already published on that subject, but I've got a new one coming.
Uh-huh.
I have identified sulfate deficiency in the cerebral spinal fluid in the brain as a key factor in autism. It disrupts the ability to generate new neurons. The neurogenerative procedure depends upon the sulfates, and that's because the melatonin is unavailable. The melatonin is a product, of course, of the shikimate pathway. It's also because sulfate is disrupted. Sulfate synthesis, sulfate transport, sulfate waste are all a problematic, with glyphosate. Glyphosate really disturbs the sulfate system.
And the shikimate pathway is the pathway that glyphosate, that Roundup specifically interrupts. We have about a minute and a half left here, Dr. We're talking with Dr. Stephanie Senef. Have you gotten any blowback from Monsanto on this? Are they on the warpath?
Well, they are. I mean, they certainly are trying to make sure that people believe that I'm not credible. I have an undergraduate degree in biology from MIT. I won an award as a sophomore, as the sophomore most likely to succeed in the field of chemistry from the American Chemical Society. So, I mean, I know biology. I know chemistry.
Yeah.
My PhD is in electrical engineering and computer science. And actually, the electrical engineering is important, too, because it allows me to figure out electricity in the body, which is extremely extremely critical part of what's messed up in the biology.
Yeah, these are neural pathways that are screwed up in autism.
It's electricity. And then my thesis was on a model for auditory processing of speech in the brain. So I know a lot about, how the brain processes. I know a lot about neuroelectricity, this kind of thing.
So what should we do? Should we just don't eat anything that doesn't say organic?
I absolutely think we should ban it. Well, everyone individually should buy only organic food. That's what we do.
Right.
Luckily, it's available and it's growing, and I'm very, very enthusiastic about that. I love, anytime I meet someone who's an organic farmer, I just want to hug them. They're so special.
Yeah. Yeah, but then in general, we need to ban Roundup, is your suggestion.
It needs to be banned because it's not just destroying our health. It's destroying the soil health. It's actually a major contributor to global warming, in my opinion. I'm working on that right now.
Because it's preventing carbon reabsorption by microbes and things?
It messes up the microbes. It messes up the soil. It messes up the water. I mean, it messes up everything. And, of course, it's everywhere, too, when people aren't testing it enough. I mean, the U.S. government is extremely negligent.
It's amazing.
In the testing of the food.
At some point in the next month or so, I'd like to have a longer conversation with you about this. Thanks so much for coming on our program, Dr. Senef.
I'm delighted.
Great talking with you. This is amazing stuff. Dr. Stephanie Senef of MIT.